So we're going to go through the assembly of the viable pitch propeller mechanism. I've got all the parts laid out here. And so it can be assembled in different sub-assemblies. So we're going to start with the propeller sub-assembly. So it's these parts here, the two hub halves, five blades, five worm gears for the blade, five thrust washers, and a hub nut as well. So the way the blades go in the hub, you can see they fit in the five locations around, and the worm gears go in the holes next to it. And the way the worm gears are retained is that you have these small thrust washers that go in this groove around the thrust the spur gear, worm gear, sorry. And so, in order to put it in place, take the worm gear, feed it through, and then place a thrust washer next to it. So you have to have the worm gear pushed all the way through, but then you take it slightly back. It's upside down now. You have to have the chamfered edge towards you when you do this, and so you jiggle it slightly up, there it goes. And then if you push the worm gear, you have a 5 millimeter gap between the hub face and the spur gear. And so you can go ahead and do that for the five worm gears. And then when you have the five worm gears installed, you can go ahead and install the propeller blades. Try to put them all more or less in the same direction. And then to close it, you just take the front hub halves and place it on the top, like so. When the 12s touch, then it's in place, and you can take the hub screw it in the front, and you have this spanner as well that's made to tighten it. So you don't need to tighten it very much, just so that it stays there, but don't go too hard on it, it's only plastic. And then it's a good idea to run every blade. So here you can see it's running quite smoothly, but I did some breaking in first, so it's a good thing to make the blade turn a few turns each way, just so that it basically breaks in with the worm gear and that it doesn't create too much friction later on. So yeah, you can start adjusting the blades so that they are all more or less in the same direction, so that when we mount it on the system later, they all face the same direction. So here I put all the blades in the plane of of the hub. Let me see. Okay, looks good. And so you can set this aside for now. Then we're going to assemble the main shaft and the main housing. So the housing basically is these two parts, the front housing and the rear housing. They only fit together with centering of the on this circle and the indexing on this small pin that comes out. So just place them together. They are not held together, they will be held by the assembly of the rotor, so yeah. You have to be careful not to disassemble it before it's assembled. Then, so we take the main shaft. You can start by placing a bearing around it. And then the spacer number one. So spacer number one, it's you've got number two here, so it's slightly shorter than spacer number two, and it doesn't have the chamfer on it. So yeah, don't mistake one for the other, they're not the same length. The second shortest or second longest spacer, you put it here. And then we're going to fit this through the front of the front housing, so like so. And on the rear, you take the second bearing number one, place it around here. Take the rear shaft nut, which is this one, so threaded on the inside, and there is the small indents on the back for tightening. So you can start tightening it. So it might not tighten all the way on the first time, so if you go back and forth, it will get there eventually. Again, some breaking in of the plastic parts together, and you've got this small spanner as well to do the final tightening. It's not really needed, but it was fun making the tools as well for the assembly. And so yeah, just yeah, gentle tightening. Just needs to stay in place, nothing more. Bearings are not fully functional. Sometimes you can see the rollers move compared to the inner and outer rings, but if they stay together, it's not a problem. They just glide or slide inside the parts anyway, so even if the bearing tend to stick during the printing, it's not a big problem. And so, yeah, now that we've got this assembled, you can look, we have so small keys on the shaft, top and bottom, and also small keys on the housing, top and bottom. So we're trying to align those more or less. And on the rear planetary assembly, we've got the matching keys and keyways on the top, bottom, and here as well. And they will go to the back. But before we put it in, we take the planet axes, slide them in. And then we can go ahead and put it together. So need to find the keyway position. Oh, there it is. And so we can place it back now. So careful when you move it, because the planet axes are free to move. So if you pull the planetary gear a bit, then you might have the axes fall at the back. So yeah, I leave it like this. It's a bit easier. Next part is the spider, so just this small part. Place it on the three axes, slide it in, and there it is. Next part is the front planetary assembly. So same thing as the rear. When you print it, actually, it might not run properly. The first time you might have some adhesion between the parts. Due to the low clearances on the printer. So just move it a bit like this, press it. It's flexible enough that you can move it a bit and break the small attachment between the parts. And then, yeah, just run it like this a few times to make sure it's running smoothly. And so yeah, this one you take, you keep the large gear in the front and push it towards the back like this on top of the three axes. Up, there it goes. We take the spacer number two. So that's the one with the chamfer. The chamfer is towards the front and the flat face towards the back. And it goes in the center like this. Up. Then bearing number two goes inside. And then the small spacer number three in front of it. And then you have the whole main assembly done. Just the controlling driving gear to put on top here. So just slide it through the top hole. The handle is only slid at the back, no attachment, just friction is enough to make it run. So you can see it's running fine here. And now we can assemble the propeller that we assembled earlier and put it in the front. So there you have to make sure that the all the gears are fitting to the rear gear, so everything fine here. And the last piece to insert for the assembly is the front nut, which you can start to insert by hand, and then you have the socket wrench that's made to tighten it all the way. So again, put it in contact just a bit more, no need to tighten it like crazy. And the whole variable pitch propeller is assembled, and you can put the handle at the back, the motor crank, so that then you can turn the motor as you want.